Lord Jesus, what you did is the fullest expression of love. You, God, who made us, stepping into this earth to dwell with us, to bear our sins, to live with us again, and all that we might be with you in the way that you have always wanted it to be. Our hearts are with you today. We will sing great, hear great music coming into our hearts that will draw us closer to you, and we await this opportunity. Amen.
I would just like to reiterate some things that Reverend Archer said. It is a huge pleasure for me to be able to work with musicians of this caliber and singers of this caliber. A lot of times I feel extremely inadequate when put in this position. So it is just a huge honor for me to be able to do this. I'd like to take a few minutes, if I may, and just read a little blip about Handel and the history of Handel and the Messiah. This story is from a book called Spiritual Lives of the Great Composers by author Patrick Cavanaugh. In a small London house on Brook Street, a servant sighs with resignation as he arranges a tray full of food he assumes will not be eaten. For more than a week, he has faithfully continued to wait on his employer, an eccentric composer who spends hour after hour isolated in his own room. Morning, noon, and evening, the servant delivers appealing meals to the composer and returns late to find the bowls and platters largely untouched. Once again, he steels himself to go through the same routine, muttering under his breath about how oddly temperamental musicians can be. Some of us know about that. As he swings open the door to the composer's room, the servant stops in his tracks. The startled composer, tears streaming down his face, turns to his servant and cries out, "I did think, I did see all heaven before me and the great God himself." George Friedrich Handel had just finished writing a movement that would take its place in history as the Hallelujah Chorus. If Handel's father had had his way, the Hallelujah Chorus would never have been written. His father, a surgeon slash barber, I thought that's an odd combination too, but he wanted him to be a lawyer. Even though George showed extraordinary talent as a young boy, his father refused for several years to permit him to take music lessons. Born German in 1685, raised Lutheran, a contemporary of Bach, though they never met, he moved to London after 1712 and anglicized his name. Although Handel wrote his greatest music in England, he suffered many personal setbacks there as well, falling in and out of favor with changing monarchs, competing with established English composers, and dealing with fickle, hard-to-please audiences left him confronting bankruptcy more than once. Audiences for his compositions were unpredictable, and even the Church of England attacked him for what they considered notorious practice of writing biblical dramas such as Esther and Israel in Egypt to be performed in secular theaters, all the while competing with rival opera companies for the ticket holders of London. He relentlessly drove himself to recover from one failure after another, and finally his health began to fail. By 1741, he was swimming in debt, and it seemed certain he would land in debtor's prison. Miserably discouraged, he felt forced to withdraw from public activities when two things happened. One, a wealthy friend, Charles Jenin, gave Handel a libretto based on the life of Christ, taken entirely from the Bible. Two, he received a commission from a Dublin charity to compose a work for a benefit performance. He began working August 22nd. In 6 days, part one was completed, and that is the part that we will present here today. In 9 days, part two was done, And in 6 days, part three, with two more days, it was complete. In all, 260 pages of manuscript were filled in the remarkably short time of 24 days. One of Hangul's many biographers summed up the consensus of history. Considering the immensity of the work and the short time involved, it will remain, perhaps forever, the greatest feat in the whole history of music composition. The title for the commissioned work was simply Messiah. Messiah first performed April 13, 1742, as a charitable benefit, raising £400 and freeing 142 men from debtor's prison. A year later, Hangul staged it in London. Controversy emanating from the Church of England continued to plague Hangul, yet the King of England attended the performance. As the first notes of the triumphant Hallelujah chorus rang out, the King rose. Following royal protocol, the entire audience stood too, initiating a tradition that has lasted for more than two centuries. This is why everyone stands up to even this day. Soon after this, Hangul's fortunes began to increase dramatically, and his hard-won popularity remained constant until his death. Hangul personally conducted more than 30 performances of Messiah. Many of these concerts were benefits for the Foundling Hospital, of which Hangul was a major benefactor. The thousands of pounds raised for charity from Hangul's Messiah led one biographer to note, Messiah has fed the hungry, clothed the naked, fostered the orphan more than any other single musical production in this or any country. Another wrote, perhaps the works of no other composer have so largely contributed to the relief of human suffering. The composer's own assessment, more than any other, may best capture his personal aspirations for this well-loved work. Following the first London performance of Messiah, an English lord congratulated Hangul on the excellent entertainment. Hangul replied, my lord, I should be sorry if I only entertain them. I wish to make them better.
Thank you. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. dry land, and I will shake, and I will shake. I'll shake the hands, the earth, the sea, the dry land, all nations I'll shake, and the desire of all nations shall come. The Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom ye delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts.
No.
Thank you. People
Thank you.
in peace. Have a wonderful rest of your day.
Thank you.